Are seed oils the nutritional boogeyman? If you think about it, seed oils have been around in human diets for only a short amount of time, and chances are you probably have some in your pantry right now. They are highly processed vegetable oils made from corn, soy, sunflower, canola, and other plants, and they are made through a chemical process where they're bleached, refined, and heated so they can be usable. But how bad are they is the real question. Well, if you scroll through TikTok, the internet, and watch a couple of podcasts, chances are you'll find a doctor somewhere telling you how horrible they are for you. In this video, I'll be sharing with you a short history of these oils. We'll talk about omega-3s and 6s and why they're relevant to this discussion, as well as share with you my thoughts and opinions on seed oils and whether or not you should be avoiding them. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Let's talk about what seed oils are guilty of. They are guilty of making you sick, causing everything from heart disease and diabetes to leaky gut and even brain fog. That's why Dr. Kate Shanahan, who helped create the pro nutrition program for the LA Lakers, referred to seed oils as the Hateful Eight, not to be confused with the Quentin Tarantino movie. Comment down below if you've seen it. What are they? Canola oil, corn, cottonseed, sunflower, soybean, safflower, grapeseed, and rice bran oil. She blames these oils for robbing our health and metabolism, but let's take a step back and go back in time. How were these oils introduced into our daily lives? Well, it wasn't until the early 1900s that the technology to make seed oils was invented, resulting in a product you can still find on today's grocery shelves called Crisco. I'm sure you've seen it. Procter & Gamble made this from a cooking fat they derived from cottonseed oil that looked like lard. They brought their bestseller Crisco to market and went on an advertising spree to sell the idea that the oil they made was healthier than saturated animal fats for cooking at the time. What was insane, in my opinion, is when we take a look at the literature, it is worth noting that AHA, the American Heart Association, had a significant conflict of interest since in 1948, it had received $1.7 million or about $20 million in today's dollars from Procter & Gamble, the makers of Crisco oil, to push this narrative. And guess what? It worked. People got convinced. It took them 5 years and the company was selling tens of millions of pounds of Crisco thanks to the AHA. This opened the door for more companies to do the same with other vegetables. And today, they're known as seed oils. But why are they so hated? Well, the first reason is because of their fat composition, and pay close attention to this and tell me if it makes sense. Seed oils are high fat food. That doesn't mean it's unhealthy, but the kind of fat these oils contain is more important. When looking at the different types of fatty acids, omega-3s tend to get a lot more of the positive press. They're the anti-inflammatory fats that can improve heart health. Omega-6 polyunsaturated fats, on the other hand, are inflammatory fats. Seed oils are predominantly high in omega-6. A healthy person has about 2% of polyunsaturated fat in their body fat, but on average, a person can have as much as 30% of polyunsaturated fat in their tissues. That said, over the last 50 plus years, consumption of omega-6 fatty acids have skyrocketed, especially in America, increasing 2.5 times from 1959 to 2008. And soybean oil is currently the biggest source of omega-6 fatty acids in the US because it's really cheap and found in all sorts of processed foods like your vegetable oils that don't have any vegetables. It's literally just soybeans. Here's a chart with some common fats and oils. Now, that's not to say that get rid of all forms of omega-6 polyunsaturated fat. Our bodies will work best when the ratio of omega-6 and omega-3s are balanced. You need both these types of fats. It's only when omega-6 gets too high when you'll start running into some inflammatory conditions. But what if there's an element of guilty by association involved? I mean, that's what the skeptics will say, right? Harvard Medical School flat out says, no need to avoid healthy omega-6 fats. They report many studies showed that rates of heart disease went down as consumption of omega-6 fats went up. And a meta-analysis of 6 randomized trials found that replacing saturated fat with omega-6 fats reduced the risk of heart attacks and other coronary events by 24%. Wow, so if that's the case, what gives, right? So here's what I think is happening. You know how people say how good they felt after they cut out seed oils? But you have to ask them, how did they cut them out? Because remember, seed oils are used in commercially fried foods and ultra-processed foods. A diet high in these foods is not great at all for your health in the long run, and probably won't make you feel good either in the short term. But what else are these same foods really high in? 1, added sugar, 2, sodium, refined flour, no fiber and nutrients. So if someone stops eating them and feels better, it's likely because of the foods themselves, not just the seed oils they contain. Does that make sense? So maybe canola oil isn't harmful on its own, but maybe it becomes harmful when you take into account what else you're eating and your current individual health status, because that's what it comes down to, right? Your own unique story. The second reason why they're hated, and I have to agree, is because they are hidden in so many products that we consume every day. If someone wanted to rebalance their omega-3 and omega-6 ratio, it really will become an overwhelming task. I'll give you an easy example. Oatly's oat milk says this is the boring side of their packaging in bigger text than the important part, right? Why even call it boring if you're gonna call it important? I don't know. They even contain something called rapeseed oil, which is just a fancy canola oil. Same with a lot of other oat milks. You'll also find it in pre-made hummus and even salad dressings. It's crazy because sometimes you could be eating a salad that causes inflammation. We could debate that science all day long, but what we do know is this. Most Americans eat more omega-6 fats than omega-3 fats. On average, let's say 10 times more, which could explain why most of us have some type of inflammation. The omega-6 to omega-3 ratio should be ideally 2-to-1 or 1-to-1, but we are at 10-to-1, and some of us are at 20-to-1 and higher. If you wanted to rebalance this ratio, here are 4 things that I would start doing. 1. Switch to cooking with alternative oils that provide more omega-3s, like avocado oil or olive oil. The benefit of cooking with seed oils was that they had a high smoke point, but avocado oil has one of the highest, from 510 to 520 degrees Fahrenheit. For olive oil though, go with extra virgin olive oil. The country of origin should be on the bottle as well as the harvest date, and go with an extra virgin one that's in a glass bottle. 2, anything that's packaged and has a long shelf life, check to see if they contain seed oils. Oftentimes they'll contain BHQ, BHA, and BHT, which are already banned by other countries. 3, learn how to make your own salad dressing. It's not easy finding a salad dressing with olive oil, but it's very easy to make your own. 4, ask the restaurants you frequent what type of oil they're using for cooking. Almost every restaurant will use soy, canola, or some vegetable oil blend. But comment down below if you know of any restaurant that doesn't use seed oils. I'm curious to hear from you guys. Some restaurants will even reuse their frying oil, which means this oil is already sitting on the equipment. Think about it. Those fryers and grills, it's gonna get in your food. And on top of that, restaurants buy condiments and salad dressings in bulk from Kraft, Hellman's, and Hidden Valley, which can all have seed oils. And 5, make your own food at home so you can have the ultimate control. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys. What are your thoughts on seed oils? Leave them in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe. I post anywhere from 2 to 7 times a week, so you know where to find me. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.